Welcome to the coolest stuff on the planet.
So today's top secret mission, we are going to dance.
Oh my God, dancing for work? We get to do this?
That's right.
Oh, that's awesome. Where are we going?
Madagascar.
Oh my gosh, we're in Madagascar.
It's awesome. But first I have to ask you, Matt, do you dance?
I cut rugs.
You've been known to cut one or two?
No. I don't dance at all. I'm sorry. I'm a guy.
So dancing, what is it?
The basic motive behind dancing, right? Like if you look at animals, a lot of it is mating ritual, trying to show off so the opposite sex will want to mate with you.
And that's also true in humans as well.
You could probably make that argument pretty easily. But, you know, humans have utilized it for other things like storytelling, war dances.
Right. Yeah, it's not just a way to get a partner, but also a way to communicate, to express emotions. So that's dancing.
Okay. So why is it important in Madagascar?
Well, and this is fun, and this is kind of a leap, pun intended.
Okay.
But lemurs in Madagascar sort of dance.
Really? Okay. Is this the whole mating thing, or is this for a different kind of dance?
Well, no, they don't actually dance. But what they do, it looks like they're dancing.
Okay, so we're talking about the sifakas,
Yeah, it's sifakas or sifakas, we're not really sure, but it's very well-known kind of lemur in Madagascar. This lemur has a special way of getting around on the ground.
Yes, it sashays. I think this is the best way to put it. It literally sideways hops on the ground, and it uses its arms to kind of steady itself.
Right. And this is because this kind of lemur, it's a tree-dwelling animal.
Mm-hmm.
So it's excellent. It's excellent at hopping from tree to tree, but when it gets on the ground, it isn't made quite right for walking on all fours.
Its front legs or its arms are way too short for it to kind of like a human. Our arms are too short to walk on all fours correctly and be able to move fast enough.
Right.
And plus it has really strong back legs, so it really doesn't even need its front legs except to kind of hang on and hold on to trees.
Right. Oh, one other cool fact I know you'd like about these lemurs. They can jump, when they jump from the ground up to a tree, they can jump 30 feet. So imagine that's like if you jump from the ground to, say, like the top of a telephone pole.
That's not a problem. I can do that.
You can do that in real life?
Yeah. Standard Tuesday afternoon. That's what I do. Okay.
Well, I can't do it, so it's impressive.
Well, and you could also say that the way these things move through the trees, it is almost like this its own little dance, because they literally will jump to a tree and then immediately jump to the next tree. And because of the way they're swinging, the way they're jumping from tree to tree, they have to turn 180 degrees in the middle of the air in order to get to the other tree.
Yeah, it's wild. And we should say that, of course, Madagascar, scientists say it separated from Africa about maybe 160 million years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's the separate, like, isolated island. And so
yes,
that's how all these interesting and unusual animals developed, you know, in an isolated
it's
way.
It's a giant Galapagos kind of thing.
Yeah, it's crazy.
But other really cool stuff about Madagascar, it's considered the fourth biggest island on the Earth, which is kind of awesome. And it's hugely varied. So you've got everything from grasslands to deserts to beaches to mountain ranges. Just everything on this island.
So it's got everything you could want when you visit. I mean,
yes. If you lived on that island and you weren't able to sail anywhere, you'd be okay, because you could experience everything you'd need to experience in life probably on Madagascar.
Indeed.
Yep.
Oh, and one thing we mentioned before, the fact that Madagascar was isolated means that about 80% of its animals and its plants are unique.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see really weird animals there, like bunches of lemurs. Also, apparently, you can see the world's biggest and smallest chameleons.
And those things are ridiculously cool.
So Madagascar, full of lemurs.
Yes.
Full of animals.
Lots of dancing.
Creepy and otherwise.
Yes.
Amazing place to visit.
Go there. Do it.
For more on this and thousands of other topics, visit howstuffworks.com. And let us know what you think. Email travelpodcast@howstuffworks.com. Don't forget to check out our other podcasts, free on iTunes.